Hi, Andrew here. I'm trying to speak a little bit softer tonight as everyone's gone to bed and I'm up because I've been having some issues trying to upload this last video that I created of the RX100 Mark IV. Now, let me see if I got it around. Okay, so I'm back. I got the camera and I love the Sony RX100 Mark III, so was really excited to be getting this one. Unfortunately, I got this one from lensrentals.com. Now, typically, a fantastic company, and I love to rent from them. This is in no way a paid advertisement for them. I'm not getting paid for it in any way. But this particular version, this particular model, is overheating tremendously and shutting down after only a few minutes, to the point that I can only get like a minute and 30 seconds out of it in the end. So initially it goes up to 5 minutes, and then I go to record again and I get about maybe 3 or 4 minutes, and then 2 minutes, and then eventually I get down to like a minute and a half to about 30 seconds. I've documented this a little bit in the video, and towards the end of the video you see a little screen that pops up and says the device is overheating, please shut down. I love this camera, I do. This is my go-to camera. It's just so portable, it feels like its weight. It's worth its weight in gold, really. It's really opened up my photography to another level as well, which I'll get into in other videos. But I was really excited about the 4K ability on this one, only to find out that actually it has some massive drawbacks. So I want to do some research. Someone in a previous video that I've posted that I might end up pulling, I'm not sure. Right now what I've done is I've unlisted the video. So my subscribers, if you're one of them, you have the link, it's still available, but only 22 minutes of the video is available. So I'm recording this, adding this onto the very beginning of the video, so you get this little disclaimer. I'm sorry for all the uploads. The first time I uploaded it and put it live on YouTube, the audio was way out of whack, very, very loud indeed. I didn't want anyone to be seeing that, so I yanked that, uploaded it again with corrected audio levels. But what happened was only 22 minutes of the video is available, and I'm not sure why. So this clip here is going on at the very beginning, before the bit that I actually did record, which is about 30 minutes long. And I've been taking the RX100 Mark IV out the last several days as much as I could. And all I was able to do in the end is record little snippets here and there and put those together. So hopefully in the video after this one that you're seeing, my next upload after this will be the incredible 4K quality from the RX100 Mark IV. Again, sorry for all the messing around. Not sure what's happening, but hopefully it's been sorted out now. I have no clue as to what's been happening with the uploads. So, that being said, I got a few things I want to show you in time. One of them is, now, the RX100 is such a small camera, so I wanted to build a little rig to carry the camera, and you're gonna laugh, but I built this of different parts, the cheapest shorter mount I could buy. I purchased a 7-inch digital display, which I've been able to hack to plug into the RX 100 Mark IV and Mark III. I got a slide mount for the camera itself. I bought some 15mm 12-inch rails or rods, articulating arm, and some other bits and pieces. Now, the cool thing about this is I'm not sure I'm gonna have everything hooked up onto this. It's a little bit overkill. Maybe I don't need this section, but that's okay. What I'm gonna do is end up mounting this on a tripod, because I'm actually doing a ton of interviews over the next coming weeks after this week is up. I've got a big update that's due to be released maybe a week and a half from now, just to let you know exactly what's going on. Just life stuff, you know, you have plans and then like life happens. It's all good though, nothing's really changed, it's just a couple of small delays. So yeah, I want to show you what I did, where I got it, all the parts, and that's going to be for a whole slew of interviews for many, many individuals, and that's for another project altogether. Some of you know exactly what that's about. Now, without any further ado, here is the review of the Sony RX100 Mark IV. And don't forget, in a couple of days, I'm going to release a video with some of the 4K footage so you can see exactly what the quality of that is like. It's been a bit of a bum week. I've been trying to get out into some beautiful weather here in northern New Jersey in the USA. But unfortunately, it's been a bit overcast every time I've been able to get out. But hopefully, what I have been able to catch is of interest and still stuns the socks off you anyway. So I was able to catch a few minutes out and about with the camera, with the 4K. So enjoy. So I got some pretty exciting news. Here is my Sony RX100 Mark III. I'm actually recording with my other RX100 Mark III. And right here is fresh delivery from lensrentals.com. This is not a paid review of them, but this is the Sony RX100 Mark IV 4K video. So let's check this out. Let's see what the quality is like. Let's see what the functions and abilities are. I'm going to create another video after this particular video showing you recording ability and quality, etc., of the Sony RX100 Mark IV. So let's see. Warning, this carton has been sealed with pilfer-proof tape. Pilfer-proof. There's a word. I want to think of, it's a little bit overcast right now, but I want to think of somewhere pretty cool to take the camera. Cool. I got a return receipt shipping label. And it goes back to Tennessee. I've used this company a few times to rent lenses. So it comes very nicely packaged, to air package. Packaging bubble thingies. Let's get rid of this. Has foam padding all on the interior. Foam top. So this is the box I used to send it back. I have a QR code, lens rentals with a serial number tag. That's kind of cool. We have a battery, the NPBX1 and charger. This, I have about 5 or 6 of these batteries upstairs, so that's nice. And there is a pretty much mark-free camera. I'm going to get this and present it much better in a moment. It's got some new settings. PASMMR movie HFR, and then that's the panorama view, and then scene. The same flash. The Mark IV on this model has a knurled grip. On the Mark III, this is more like a ribbed grip. So that's a difference. So let's check something out. On the Mark III, when the camera was off and you did the viewfinder, it would start. And then when you pushed it back in previously, it would switch off. This isn't too small for some of you to see. This one is the Mark III, this one is the Mark IV. So as you can see in the Mark III, we have all spaces filled. We've got image size, aspect ratio, quality, panorama size, panorama direction, and the file format. If we go to file format, which on the Mark IV is on the next page, and we'll go to file format here, which is at the bottom, you can see the differences on the Mark IV, the XAVCS 4K, and on the Mark III, we just have XAVCS as the highest version. And to be honest, it's been absolutely fantastic for me. I've been very happy with that. Let's go back. Let's go to window 2. And then on this page, we have record settings. I've set the record settings on the Mark IV as 30p 100. On the Mark III, you have 60p 50. You can do 120p 50, but on the Mark IV you have HFR, which you can really record in a much faster frame rate to go for those really super slow speed movies. Which I'll be testing out over the next few days. Window 3. See the difference for each. Drive mode, focus mode. It's pretty much here is where you see the difference in the tab settings, as there's different settings on each camera now. If we go to the Mark III, page 4, Mark IV, page 4, you start to see some of the differences again. Next page. You know, I really recommend that if you have a Mark II, Mark III, Mark IV, really delve into the camera. There's a lot of hidden settings here which can truly change the quality of your experience with the camera, taking pictures, recording film, or recording movies. Not film, of course. You can auto dual record here, it seems, so you can set up dual modes to record. Now, you do have the steady shot on the Mark IV. And if we go into the steady shot settings, there's off and there's standard. I've done some walking around earlier holding the camera. I'll do more over the next couple of days, so when I put up the true 4K content, which I will have to edit in Final Cut, I'll put it up so you can see the beauty, the difference, the quality. But there's no ability to go to the active or the intelligent active mode. You can only do off or standard. I think what's going to happen is it's truly going to cut into that 4K screen size. You know, it's just math, really. If you're going to steady the footage, you want to be able to shrink the screen so you can take care of any possible movements. Intelligent active would really shrink up the pixel range, the space, the size of the screen. So, Mark III powered off from non-use. So let's go to steady shot. Okay, we'll go to screen 9. So it looks like you got microphone levels, wind noise reduction, etc. And what have you. So let's go up and into the cog settings, the general settings for the camera. So you got zebra on the Mark IV, manual focus assist, which I love, focus magnification time, grid line, marker display, and marker settings. Haven't played with that, so I can't truly tell you that I know exactly what all of that is about, but let's go to the next screen. You know, get into what your camera does, play with the settings. You might find that you're getting frustrated at your camera simply because you're not understanding how it operates. So play around with it. It's meant the world to me to find out some of the abilities that my Mark III has. Yeah, I like having the movie button on. So no matter what camera setting I'm actually using, if I press record on the back using the record button, it just automatically starts recording a movie. Let's go up into the Wi-Fi. Send a smartphone, blah, blah, blah. We know what that is. That's all the same, as far as I can tell. Application list. There is nothing on this one. Let me go into application list on this one. Not sure if this is the camera. Yeah, on this one, I've recorded a slew. I've downloaded a slew of apps from the Sony store and love them. You know, there's better ways of doing some of these types of images, but still, again, it's well worth the playing around. So let's go back. So this is the view or the play settings. Same. I think this screen has, I've adjusted this screen, maybe settings, brightness, contrast to this one, which is why it might look a little different. And it's funny, on this one you have the 4K still image PB. I'm not sure what that is. Again, motion interval adjustment. So again, you know, there's even some effects that I would like to take a look at to understand if something can be improved for my usage. Let's go to the toolbox. Okay, so everything's kind of set auto on these. Let me set monitor brightness. Let's go to number two. As a motorcycle passes outside. The same number of tabs, just some slightly different settings. This is what I like on the on this particular, on the Mark IV, is you have the area settings, so you can set the area to, I've set it to New York, and then the copyright info. So let's go down into the copyright info so you can see that. So it will write the copyright info to the metadata on, or the EXIF data for all of the images. I can set the photographer name, set the copyright info, display the copyright info, and so on. So that's kind of cool. I know the format is set up slightly different. I was able to take my old SD card from the Mark III and put it right into the Mark IV without any issues. One of them didn't work as it wasn't fast enough for the 4K, but when I put in one of the other cards, it worked fine. So on screen 5 of the toolbox, you have the format. And on screen 6, that's basically that's it for the menus. If you're wondering what this thing is over here, let's see if I can zoom in. A few years ago, I had a workshop, and let's turn on a light. I had a workshop, and in that workshop, I created wooden products. Now, before I said goodbye to the workshop, because business was okay, but I was only doing business for some reason with California and Texas. I was selling quite a few products out there, but it was just too labor intensive and I couldn't keep up with demand. So for now, things have kind of been stalled and put on pause. But that is a Kickstarter oak speaker called the Oakman. Recycled oak, wireless, Bluetooth actually connection from your phone to the speaker, and it has a nice little sound to it. Let's turn it on its side, and you know, just small feet on the back, big feet on the front. What a big sound! But yeah, you know, who knows? Maybe in time I'll kind of go back to that. Here I have two Sony RX100s. The one on the left is a Mark III, and the one on the right is a Mark IV. The one on the left, the Mark III, is set for the highest recording video setting that it will go. And I've also set, I think it's the XAVCS, and it's 60p 50. And the one on the right, the Mark IV, is set for XAVCS 4K 30p 100. So I'm going to start recording at exactly the same time on both cameras, and I'm going to see how long the cameras record for before they turn off. On both of my RX100 Mark IIIs, it's 30 minutes. So hopefully this test will show that they've improved that or they've changed that in some way. Either way, let's see what happens. So they're both recording. The Mark III has started a little bit before. So I'm just gonna leave this and see what happens. And we'll come back in about 25 minutes time. So I come back 27 minutes later. The Mark IV has turned off. The Mark III is still going strong, but I know this is going to turn off roughly about 30 minutes. This has never been an issue for me since all my video recording has been under that time. And since I have two, what I do is I start one, then like 30 seconds later, I start the other one. So I can stop recording, start recording again to keep on recording up to that hour mark if I need to, and the same with the other one. So let's start up the Mark IV again. Let's press play. Now the battery's still good and I still have 2 hours 40 minutes left on the 128 gig SD card. So let me press play. This one is, I'm trying to find how long this is. So let's press play just to see. So I'm going to fast forward. I mean, it stopped recording after 5 minutes. Are you kidding me? Holy crap. Okay, so what I'm going to do, this is a bigger issue than I thought. So I'm going to stop recording on this one, because I know the Mark III does half an hour. I'm going to put this one aside. This one I'm going to bring front and center. Start recording again. In actual fact, let me reposition this camera. So maybe somewhere this is stated clearly in the literature when online, I'm not sure, I have not looked, but this for me is a serious drawback, and I'm just going to double check that this is in fact true for this camera. So I've got it here, I've got it set up on my subject, I'm going to press record. Let's see what happens. So I'm going to leave. Actually, I'm going to have to stop recording on this particular camera and swap out the battery since it's almost dead. And then I'll start recording again just so we can follow through and see what the recording time is on the 4K. So the Mark IV has been recording 4K video now for 1 minute and 37 seconds. So let's see how far it will go before it turns off. So really, not knowing what to expect, I set up the Mark IV and I start recording. I've speeded up this footage quite considerably. It's 3:54 minutes, and at the 4 minute mark, the overheating sensor in orange towards the top of the center of the screen comes on. And even though at this point it's no longer recording, it eventually turns off. So I decide that the camera for me is pretty useless at this point. I want it for recording 4K video, and at this point in time, it's not doing that. I cannot record interviews, I cannot take it out into nature, and I'm a little upset because I've seen, and there it is, turned off You see a very dusty screen. I apologize for that. But at this point, I've heard of too many Sonys having this overheating issue. I didn't believe them. But there you go.
Oh my god. Well, what good is that to me then? So, this, the Sony RX100 Mark IV cut out after 3 or 4 minutes, which is absolutely crazy. So, I'm just going to do one more test before I use this video. It just seems so ridiculously short. I mean, I still have 2.5 hours worth of video to be fit onto this card. I don't get it. I need someone to explain to me why. This has probably just put the last nail in the coffin for me as far as 4K video goes with the RX100 Mark IV.
Crazy.
So more than anything, as both cameras turn off, the Mark IIIs I'm very happy with. The Mark IV is turning off after hardly any time recording in 4K mode. So I'm a little bit dubious as to whether this is a properly functioning unit. I don't know if this one is failing. Or if there's obviously, like I said, just like some sort of an error. Let's go through some of control settings on top. So we'll start by turning it on, and let's hit button. The only thing I guess really I kind of have a little bit of a complaint about is the very small grip section here. The front, it looks fantastic, it looks very slick, it feels like it's worth, it feels like it costs a lot of money for how big it is. But I think a rubberized grip that kind of comes standard here, or some sort of knurled front or what have you, would it be a slight improvement, and I think many would welcome it. So in the front we have, or on the top, sorry, we have the film settings. This is recording for movie, and here we have the high frame rate, HFR. Now with the high frame rate, if we go into the menu settings, let's go there's the HFR settings, record settings. I'm going to go to 960 feet per second, quality priority. This will go 16 times slow motion. So that's set for that. The only thing I found is that you really need to be in a well-lit situation if you record this way. And to record, it's not normal as well. You need to press like the middle menu button down here, the little scroll wheel. You need to press this little menu, this little button, and then I think it's press it again and it will record. But it gives you instructions. This is for panorama, sweep panorama, seen. You're all pretty much familiar with this. So then you go through portrait, action, macro, landscape, sunset, night scene, handheld twilight, night portrait, anti-motion blur, pet, gourmet, fireworks, high sensitivity, and background to portrait, sports action, macro, landscape, so on. So that's that. I mean, that's all good, but I prefer to use aperture or shutter priority or manual, just because I like having the full control over the quality of my pictures. Plus, it then gives you a raw image, which is much better quality. The auto, let's see, you can shoot selecting either intelligent auto or superior auto. Intelligent auto automatically identifies the scene's characteristics and shoots a photo. Superior auto, the device beautifully shoots automatically while reducing blurring and noise. As you can see, my Tascam DR70D and the Rode mic up on top. Recording this audio. Program auto, aperture priority, shutter priority, and manual. And then memory recall. And I think with memory recall, yeah, you get three different settings. And in these three settings, you can set your set all of your individual parameters for each of your three chosen modes that maybe you use most often. And then again, you have your movie settings. And, you know, there's a slew of movie settings beyond this. I can still record an XVACS. You know, the reason I wanted this was for the 4K. I'm just not sure that this camera is acting the way it should. So a little bit perplexed and a little bit disappointed, to be honest. But over the next couple of days, I'm going to do some super slow motion videography. And I'm going to do some super 4K filming out and about in nature and see if I can get some beautiful shots for you to see. So that's it. I hope this has been helpful. I hope this is giving you some sort of idea of what this camera's about. Personally, I love the Mark III. It would take me a little bit of getting used. This, for me, has been a bit of a step back as far as the 4K goes. I was hoping it was going to be better. I thought for some reason as well the image size was going to be much bigger. I thought it was going to be around about 40 megs for a JPEG or a still image from the Mark IV, but it's about 20 megs. So for my settings, it's a little bit under what the Mark III does. I like to shoot in 16:9 ratio, not 4:3 or any of the other settings. So that's it. This has been Andrew Jones for Artistic Brit and just reviewing the Sony RX100 Mark IV.